Hi students, today we are going to learn about multiplying decimals. First, let us see how to round off decimal numbers. To round off a decimal number, we follow these steps. Step 1. Look for the place value to which we need to round off the decimal number. Step 2. Mark the digit in that place. Step 3. Check the digit to the immediate right of the marked digit. Step 4. If the digit is equal to or greater than 5, add 1 to the marked digit and remove all the digits to its right. Step 5. If the digit is less than 5, remove all the digits to the right of the marked digit. Next example, round off the decimal number 1.098 to the 100th place. The digit 8 lies to the right of the 100th place and is greater than 5. So 1.098 is rounded off to 1.10. Next, 248.9456 to 3 decimal places. The digit 6 lies to the right of the 1000th place and is less than 5. So 248.99453 is rounded off to 248.945. Adding and subtracting decimals. First, we are going to use the grid model to add and subtracting decimals. In this model, we will use grids to add and subtract decimal numbers. In this figure, the first square represents the one whole number and the second square, each column represents 0.1 and in the third square, each small square represents 0.01. To add 0.18.22, first represent 0.18 on the grid. The first square represent 0.18 on the second square, shade 0.22 on the same grid. Next, count the total number of squares. Here, the total is 40. So, 0.18 plus 0.22 is equal to 0.40. Similarly, to subtract 0.14 from 0.46, first represent 0.46 on the grid. Then cut out the portion to be subtracted and count the remaining squares. In the first square, represent 0.46 on the grid. Next, cut out 0.14 on the same grid. Next, count the remaining squares. Here, 32 squares remain. So, 0.46 minus 0.14 is equal to 0.32. Next, area model. Let us add 3.2 and 2.1 using the area model. The first diagram represents 3.2 and the second diagram represents 2.1. Then add 3.2 plus 2.1, count the wholes and tens. To get the answer, we get 5.3. Next example, solve 3.2 minus 2.30 using the area model. The first diagram represent 3.42 and the second diagram represent 2.30. Next 2.3, 3.42 model, we are left with one whole, one tenth and two hundredths, which represents 1.12. Next, place value model. Let us add 32.68 and 45.98 using the place value model. First add tens, then add ones, then add tens, next add hundredths, then we get 78.66 as the sum of 32.68 and 45.98. To add or subtract, decimal numbers, we need to ensure that they are like decimals, which means that they have the same number of decimal places. For example, 33.1 and 47.9 are like decimals, while 56.878 and 45.98 are unlike decimals. Decimal numbers can be converted to like decimals by adding one or more zeros to the extreme right of the shorter number until it has the same number of decimal places as the longer number. Let us subtract 43.9 from 55.342. 40 and 55.342 are unlike decimals. To turn them into like decimals, we add two zeros to the extreme right of 43.9. After the calculation, we get 11.532 as the difference of 55.432 and 43.9. Next, multiplying decimals. Let us multiply 0.6 into 0.3 using grids. 0.6 is the same as 6 divided by 10 and 0.3 is the same as 3 divided by 10. So, 0.6 into 0.3 is the same as 6 by 10 of 3 by 10. First, shade 3 columns of the grid in one color to show 0.3, then shade 6 rows of the grid in another color to show 0.6. Look for the common shaded portion to get the answer. The first diagram, first 3 columns represent 0.3, and in the second diagram, 6 rows represent 0.6. The common portion is shown using the color blue. In the third diagram, 18 small squares are common to both shaded regions. So, 0.6 into 0.3 is equal to 0.18. Multiplication using the area model. We can use the area model in the same way for multiplication as we did for addition and subtraction. Let us solve 4.3 into 2.2 using the area model. Then we get 8 wholes, 14 tens, that is equal to 1 whole and 4 tens and 6 hundredths, which is equal to 9.46. Next, we are going to multiply the decimal numbers using normal multiplication. Let us solve 4.57 into 3.2. First, we solve 457 into 32. 457 into 32 is equal to 14,624. The number of decimal digits after multiplication should be equal to the sum of the number of decimal digits that are multiplied. Number of decimal digits after multiplication is equal to 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So, 4.57 into 3.2 is equal to 14.624. Next, multiplying the decimal numbers by 10, 100 and 1000. When we multiply a decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000, we keep the digits the same and simply move the decimal point to the right as many places as the number of zeros in the multiplier. 1 for 10, 2 for 100 and 3 for 1000. Solve 25.18 into 100. There are 2 zeros in 100. So, we move the decimal point 2 places to the right. So, 25.18 into 100 is equal to 2518. Next, 0.0098 into 1000. There are 3 zeros in 1000. So, we move the decimal point 3 places to the right. So, 0.0098 is into 1000 is equal to 9.8. Next, multi-step word problems. Example, Jarna has 8 knives. She buys each of them a ball costing 12.32 rupees, a bat costing 31.76 rupees and a glove costing rupees 82. How much does she spend altogether? First, we need to calculate how much money Jarna spends to buy the items for one knife. To do this, we add 12.32 rupees, 31.76 rupees and 82. Since these are unlike decimals, we need to turn them into like decimals. So 82 is equal to 82.00. Now we can add 12.32 plus 31.76 plus 82.00 is equal to 126.08. Jarna's spends 126.08 rupees on each knife. Let us now find out how much she spends in all by solving 8 into 126.08, multiplying like whole numbers. 8 into 12,608 is equal to 1,864. Since there are two decimal places in the factors, there should be two decimal places in the answer too. So 8 into 126.08 is equal to 1008 into 64. Jarna spends 1008.64 rupees in all.